Look at that nice new intro. Anyways, I don't know if you guys like that intro. If you do, I think that's what we're gonna be using from now on. If you liked it, comment, whatever. But anyways, hello everybody. My name is Alec, Hungry or RPGs, and today this is a gameplay that I got myself. I usually don't have a lot of gameplays. Not that I'm bad at the game, I just don't go for them. As you can see, I'm using the striker here. This is one of the games I got good with the striker. When I say I don't really go for gameplays, I don't put on a lot of guns that are good. I'm running around with like a KSG or something stupid half the time. But recently over the weekend, I've got a decent amount because I started using guns that are viable, guns that are good. But like I said, here's the striker. I don't know if I'd consider this overpowered. The only reason I put it on again, because I do have it basically fully leveled up except for golden. I don't need golden. I don't have golden on any of my guns. But the only reason I put it back on is because someone was using it against me and it would just one-shot me every time. So this is basically striker with extended mags and damage. Because range doesn't feel like it does anything to. It extends the range, but it doesn't make the damage better of the range. So it's still a fu it it's from far away, it is still like a 5-shot kill, but it just extends the range that gives you that 5-shot kill, and 5-shot kill is not even doable with most of the shotguns. Maybe the striker might be the only one you can get long range kills with like 5 shots. But that's why I'm using damage, because this gun already has great range. It doesn't have amazing damage. Usually it's a 2-shot, but you can just fire it off like it's a Mark 14 or something, and you could just kill everybody. But that brings me to the point. Is this gun overpowered? And to that, I say, I don't think so. If you put damage on it, I think it is. Because basically, this thing is ridiculously, you can fire incredibly fast. And when you've got so much damage flying at you, that is basically an instant kill from very long ranges, it feels like it's overpowered. But something with the striker is, it doesn't feel as good. It's not a big boom when you shoot the gun. There's no pump action on it. It doesn't feel satisfying when I get a kill with the striker. More satisfying than maybe like an ACR or something, a Type 95, but it's not as satisfying as like a SPAS 12 or a KSG or something. But anyways, today I'd like to talk about how the casual gamer killed Modern Warfare 3, or Call of Duty in general. Now, I saw a video, it was by a man, a very beautiful man by the name of 8Thoughts. If you don't know him, I suggest you go check him out because he does put up some pretty good content. Anyways, he was talking about how the casual gamer killed Modern Warfare 3 because they're a bigger profit margin. And profit is the main thing that these companies want. They want money, obviously. I mean, who doesn't? Maybe these guys are a little bit too greedy with their money, but regardless, you want money, I want money. Unless you're Buddhist or something, but that's besides the point. Yeah, they're a bigger profit margin. The people that watch videos on YouTube, like yourself, if you're watching this video, they're more of the hardcore players, They're the ones that they try. They might be in game battles. You might be in game battles. You like getting good stores. You play this game probably a decent amount, more than casual gamers, Some people, like Joe Blow, the mailman down the street, plays maybe once a week for 2 hours, Whereas me, I'm playing this game at least an hour a day, when I have time. If it's during the school, then no, I don't have time for that. But yeah, the casual, like, you can see how the casual gamer would, they made it so that it's easy. This game isn't necessarily easy. It's easier than some of the other Call of Duties, but I still think Black Ops was the easiest Call of Duty. But you could see that they brought back some of the things that would help, casual gamers stay into this game, not get completely destroyed by players like ourselves. Not saying I'm amazing or anything, but we aren't casual gamers. We play this game a decent amount. You might be a casual gamer, but whatever. I mean, they brought back the support class, and that is a complete blinding light saying you they're trying to help people that don't play the game this much. I mean, you don't need a kill streak to get rewards, and that's what something I like about Call of Duty. I get rewarded for the work I do, killing people and whatever else, capturing flags, helping the objective. I like that. And I think that helps casual players And so does like Assassin and Deathstreaks. You know, nobody wanted Deathstreaks to come back, but they brought it back for the casual players. You know, and I think that's casual players, no offense, is what make this game not as good as could be. You know, Deathstreaks are incredibly annoying. Final Stand, they said they weren't bringing back Last Stand or anything, but, you know, it is back. Dead Man's Hand is basically just a killstreak stopper. And that is how the casual gamer destroyed Modern Warfare 3. Maybe not destroyed it, but made it a little bit worse. Definitely worse. But then again, casual gamers aren't really on PC. So PC players, more power to you. Anyways, this gameplay's over, 29-5. Thanks for watching, bye.